Before I start this video, let me take 30 seconds to tell you something about Exergic. Exergic is India's most trusted and most experienced institute for online GATE preparation. I am Chandresh Mahajan, founder and chief educator at Exergic. I'm an All India Rank 37 in GATE Mechanical Engineering, an ex-Indian Oil officer having 7 plus years of teaching experience as of now. These are the GATE 2021 Mechanical Engineering toppers from Exergic. You can find their preparation strategy on Exergic's website. To know more about our GATE courses, you can visit our website or contact us on these details. Also, you can download Exergic GATE preparation app from Google Play Store. The link is available in the description of video. So I was discussing this question in the video course of Exergic, and generally the videos that I put here on the YouTube channel of Exergic, they are directly the videos, the clips, the lectures from the course directly. I don't have any technical video in the YouTube channel of Exergic which is not on the video course, right? I don't record anything specifically technical content for the YouTube channel. Whatever is there in the course, only some part of that comes on the YouTube channel. But this is the first such video that I am making where I am discussing something technical, which although I have told in the course, but I am specifically making this for YouTube. I was discussing this question on the metallostatic force in the casting, right? We all know the concept of metallostatic force, the types of those forces, where they act, how to find them out. But there are two things in specific in that discussion that I wanted to share. Point number one is that if you get a question where the density of molding sand is not given to you, but the density of core material is given, the material of the core that is given to you, but the density of molding sand is not given to you. And in the calculation of metallostatic force, you need the density of molding sand as well. In such situation, take the density of core same as the density of molding sand. And it is true in the other way also. If in a question you require the density of core, but question has given you the density of molding sand, it has not mentioned anything about the material or the density of core. In that situation, we consider that core is made up of the same material as the molding sand. So obviously, the density will also be same. A very small point, but very helpful in such numericals. Point number two is regarding the weight that we put to balance the metallostatic force. As we know that under the action of metallostatic force, the cope tends to go up. Cope is a molding flask, right? That will tend to go up. To keep that in balance, we put extra weight over the cope. Obviously, we do the proper ramming to ensure the material and the whole structure is strong enough. But we also put extra weight over the cope to balance it, right? Again, this is something that we have already discussed. The point here is that how much should be that weight? In that calculation, be careful to see which value is higher. Generally, the upward force that we find is higher than the weight of the cope, right? That's the general situation. So obviously, you need some extra weight to put over the cope to balance it. But the point is that there will be certain cases where the cope's weight is strong enough to balance the upward metallostatic forces. In that situation, you do not need any extra weight. For example, the question that I am discussing right now, the weight of the cope here is coming out to be 1650 newton. But the metallostatic force, net metallostatic force in the upward direction came out to be 4324.013. Obviously, this value is higher. So, net upward force acting is higher. You need to balance that by putting the extra weight. So, take the difference of the two. But just in case you find a question where this value is higher, where suppose this comes out to be 4650, the weight of the cope, then the weight is strong enough to counteract to balance the net upward force due to metallostatic reasons. So here, don't take the difference. Don't reverse it. Don't make it downward minus upward, right? That will give you incorrect answer. Answer would be zero if the weight of the cope is more than the net upward metallostatic forces. These are the two points in this whole discussion that I thought were important, and I could save the time of other students also by directly telling you the two main points of this example rather than solving the complete example. I wish you all the best.